Here we're going to focus on rollup analyses. In previous videos, we've taken a look at expression analyses. These are our basic analyses where we write out functions in our equations. Rollup analyses are just that. We will roll up several calculations to be able to handle a broader picture of what's going on in our processes. I will walk through an existing analysis example kit, which I will also link in the description. In the power generation load forecasting database, we're going to see that there's a number of rollup analyses. In this particular scenario, we have a sun gas power generation company. In that company, there are two different plants, south and west. In south, we have Karnak and Piney Woods, and in west, we have the Bryce Canyon production lines. If we take a look at each of these individually, we can see there's quite a lot of attributes on each one. And one of these attributes is the total power generation actual, down here at the bottom. Now, Karnak has that, Piney Woods has that, and Bryce Canyon also has it. What we'd like to see is if we can do a roll-up analysis so that we can know at each stage what the total power generation is for each of the plants, both south and west, as well as altogether for the entire SunGas company. If I take a look at the next level up, we can see that I have the total sum generation. Now, for west, since there's only one child attribute, it should match what's there on Bryce Canyon. We can just verify that that number is the same. And it was 844.129. And that matches. Let's take a look at the south plant. In the south region, we have 1722 megawatts. Let's take a look at Karnak and Piney Woods and make sure that that adds up. And that added together gives us our total. If we look at SunGas itself, we can see that we have a total value of 2566 megawatts, and that's including both the south and the west regions. Let's take a look at the analyses themselves and see how our roll-up calculations are configured. Later in the video, I'll walk through an example, so that way we'll configure one together. This icon indicates that this is part of a rollup calculation. We can see the analysis type here is a rollup. This shows up as gray because it's part of a template, and we're not making any changes to the individual pieces from the template. Typically, but not exclusively, rollup attributes will utilize the child elements. You are also able to make a rollup calculation on the current element that you have. To get started with building out our analysis, we want to take a look at the sample child element. Here we've chosen south. Once we've chosen the sample child element, we can see the attributes that are associated with it. Once we see the attributes associated with it, it's time to select our filters in order to make sure that we can sum up or make a rollup calculation based off of the child attributes. In this case, we'll put in total generation, and we append an asterisk so that way it adds on any and all characters. Using this filter, we can find the total generation underscore sum attribute, and that gets a check mark on the right. You can see that we can also filter based on the attribute category, as well as the attribute level. If we take a look at the other parent elements, we can see that these are arranged in a similar way. In this particular case, we've only changed our filter to total power, and that way we can get the total power generation. You can notice here that the sample child element is Karnak, as that one is under the south region. In each of these, we have them scheduled as event triggered. Now, this may cause performance problems, and depending on how many child attributes are going to be involved in this calculation, we would advise that you use a periodic scheduling to limit the amount of calculations this will have to do. I'll go over that again when we do our own example. Imagine that you had 10 plants in the south region. To get the total generation, all you have to do is put in this one filter that matches on the same child attribute. Having similar child attributes is going to be easy because you'll likely be leveraging the use of templates. In that way, you're able to see you can easily filter on a child attribute value and quickly make many different calculations using the rollup analysis. Let's take a look and make our own example for how we can use a roll-up analysis.
To configure an example of the roll-up analysis, let's go back onto another database, the oil and gas well downtime tracking full database. And again, I have two well pads, Clear Fork and Odessa, as well as a production area, West Texas. I'm going to make two roll-up analyses, one on each template, in order to make sure that we can calculate the average gas gravity at each of the sites, as well as for the entire production area. We'll start by configuring it for Clear Fork. That way our roll-up analysis is present when we go to the West Texas level, which is the production area. I'm going to do this on the template. Since these are already based off of the template, and we want this to propagate to all of the elements that are based off of that template, it makes the most sense to configure it here. Again, we'll start with the well pad. We can see there's a number of roll-up analyses on here already. We'll right-click, New, Roll-up Analysis. And all I'll have to do, since trialed elements of Clear Fork is already selected, I'll just filter on gas and filter with a star. And I can see at the top, gas gravity is now selected. I'll choose an average, and I'll map an output to a new attribute template. And I'll hit OK. When I check this in, this attribute will start collecting data for both the Odessa and the Clear Fork sites. Next, I'll go to my production area template, and I'll configure a very similar roll-up analysis. So now that we can see that we have the gas gravity average attribute, again, that is because we created it on the well pad template first. We can go over and we can make sure that we can select it. I can use the same filter to just get gas. And I'll make sure to choose the average. And I'll map it. Can also change the name. I'm going to change my triggering criteria to be periodic, and that's because this is for my entire production area. Since all of my well pads and all of their child attributes are event triggered, that means anytime any of these gas gravity events comes in, it would then trigger my production area if it were left as event triggered. By changing it to periodic, it means that my calculation will run less frequently, but I'll still get updates every 5 minutes if I leave it as the default setting. I'll check this in. And we can check and see if our production attributes are updating. So it looks like we have 0.83 for the average gas gravity from these different wells. And it looks like it's just one particular attribute on well 31 that's above that, pulling up the average. And in a few minutes, we'll expect for our point created to change to the actual value for gas gravity after it's calculated on that 5-minute interval.